In this video, we'll make an AI-generated game using this idea generated by ChatGPT, and we'll get ChatGPT to make the code as well, and then we'll get DALL-E to make the art, and this will be peak laziness. I'll have to do nothing. So I asked ChatGPT to write some scratch code that'll allow the player to move a basket with the left and right arrow keys. Here is what it generated. It's surprisingly detailed. It tells you how to make a sprite, the code you need to put on it. It also tells you to change the numbers if the speed isn't right, tells you how to test it, and it gives you suggestions for what to do later. Now, Scratch uses blocks, not actual coding, so I couldn't just copy-paste. So I pasted it into a comment, and then just dragged the blocks in. Now, ChatGPT actually tells you how to test it. You just click the green flag, and it should work. It also says we can change the numbers if we want to make it move faster or slower. Next, I got DALL-E to make a basket image that could be used in a video game. Gave me some options. Chose this one. Looks nice. Write scratch code that makes different colored balls fall from the top of the screen. Let's watch ChatGPT do its magic. Okay, this code is actually pretty good, except you shouldn't duplicate the sprite, you should make clones. Whatever, it's pretty good for an AI. Okay, I've pasted the code in a new comment. Let's drag all the stuff in. Okay, let's test it. It doesn't work. I think ChatGPT actually meant to put it a bit low, you know? Let's just pretend it did. Yeah, that works now. We can move our basket, the ball falls down, it's amazing. So I asked the AI for some scoring code, and it gave me this response. It was very long and took a long time to generate. So I copied the text into a comment, and now this is the result. So I have not tested this yet, but I've tried to copy the code as exactly as the AI has told me to, but the set ball 1 V bracket size to 0. It doesn't exist, so I use broadcasts. And also, you can't set a sprite size to 0, but I've done that anyway. It won't work. And also, ChatGPT wanted me to make them all give one score, even though I told it to only do one. Whatever, it knows best. And also, there's no when touching block, so I had to do a forever if touching. Before I can show you the finished game, we'll need to actually finish it with a health system, because that was part of the idea ChatGPT originally suggested. So your basket will change color, and then if you don't collect the right ball with the right color, you lose hearts. If you run out of health, game over. So you're seeing what the AI generated now. It's awful code, like horrible code, but I'm forced to put it in Scratch. Okay, I haven't tested any of the health stuff yet, but just putting the code in, this is absolutely awful. How much redundant stuff there is. You do not have to duplicate these. You could just have done this, like just put it at the end since it's run both times, but that's what the AI said, and it's smarter than me, so I'll do it. Now let's see if this remotely works. So my basket's red, so I can only touch red dots or I die. There's a green dot in the red dot, so that's annoying. And they're always bunched together. So the AI hasn't actually told me to run the color changing function. Oh, and I lost, but I can still move. Interesting. So I asked it when I should actually run the change color message, and it said every time we collect a ball with the right color. So I'll do that. Now let's play color match. An AI-generated scratch game. So we collect the things which match. If we don't, we die. We've got a beautiful basket and background made by DALL-E, which actually looks pretty decent. I just collected a red with a blue basket, I think. Oh, and I lost. If you like scratch challenges, this is the video for you, where I make a game with zero sprites.